This is part four of the annual PM on the Fresenius 2008K machine. The first thing I'm going to do is rebuild the bicarb and the acid handles. I start by putting a clean towel on the top of my machine and opening up the acid spike. I remove the old O-ring end filter and throw it away. And I leave that right there. And then remove the bicarb handle, throwing away the old filter. And also noticing that there's a little debris on this filter. Okay, so I make sure that these are clean as I'm doing that. And then I'll take my handles and move them over to my workbench over here. And then I'll bring my my PM kit over here, and I'll just lay my new filter there with my new O-ring, and my new filter, my O-ring there. Then I'll move that to the bench, okay? And when I get to the bench, I have to grab a special tool, just a second. I have a little thinner pair of channel locks that have a thin nose to them, so to speak. And it just seems to fit better into the actual acid handle. Sometimes these can be pretty tough. Get out. This is a real tough one. Because of how tough this one is, I'm going to be replacing, more than likely, this acid spike. I can tell it's rusted inside. That's why it's so hard to remove. Of course, rust makes a great seal, and a lot of times, it's not really what we're after. And as suspected, this is extremely rusted. As I look at this, I'm going to remove the one part that I need off of it. And simply dip into my spare parts bin, where we always have an extra acid spike for annual PMs. We almost replace these every annual PM. They're extremely cheap, and there's no reason to not replace them. So I'm just going to put a new O-ring on here. These are kind of funny. I dip these in water. It's the old rubber metal theory. Sometimes rubber and metal don't seal well without water. Okay, now I'm going to go ahead and grab the end O-ring. Give a little water on that baby too. Okay, there's my new acid spike. Throw away the old clip, the old housing, so to speak, or the spike itself. I have a new one of these in the PM kit. I have a new locking ring, which will go on to the new deal here. And I'm going to make use of this screw collar assembly here. But first I'm going to clean it by just dropping it in some RO water. And just let that sit in there for a few. Throw that away. Okay, this is going to be our new spike. I'm going to clean the inside of this acid port out. Just drop it in the RO water. I'm going to set these aside and move on to my bicarb spike here. The bicarb is always much nicer and cleaner, and I've never had to replace one yet. Again, I'm only going to replace the parts here. Richard, do you have any of my O-ring tool? They're required by the PM. Okay. I'm going to remove the two O-rings, and I want you to notice that you can see that this O-ring is very loose right now. Okay. Locking ring in the garbage. Both O-rings. Look at how loose that O-ring is. That would, loose bicarb O-rings take an effect on the machine where it takes a little longer to come up to conductivity. Okay, here's a really nice bicarb spike. Let me dip my O-ring in water. Let's put new O-rings on. Let me grab this little one here and back. Try to dip it in there. A little wah-wah. Okay. Now, I want my locking ring. So what is the locking ring? Oh, the locking ring holds the spike into the female socket. When it's fatigued, it doesn't seat as well. And that in turn could render a small leak or a little less vacuum, if you will, in the suction of that particular pump. So now I've reassembled this little guy. Kind of holds it up in the air like this. Yeah. I'm going to dip it once more in the water here. Okay, now just come on down over the top of this baby. Now screw that on the end. Like that. Turn it over. I like to get this nice and tight in there because it has a tendency to be pushed and pulled a lot and can loosen up and cause a vacuum leak in this area here. So after I finish rebuilding the spike, I just simply go back over and I drop these guys here into there. That's the new O-ring and the new filter. I'm gonna go ahead and lube this baby up, give her a little water, just for the heck of it. Okay, now we come down over the top. And this is exactly how you do the acid O-ring as well. Tighter the better. Okay, that one's done. Okay. If you were to look in here right now, I want you to notice that in the bottom of this is rust. See that rust? This was perfectly white water. That's how you can clean up some of your parts right there. Just get them cleaned up in Ardo water. Suggest that you purchase a few of these for your stock so that you have spares in-house so that you don't have to bother cleaning the line like this. And again, you rebuild this spike the same way, install it the same way, and that does complete the rebuilding of the acid and bicarb spikes. And this is the end of part four of the annual PM on the Fresenius 2008 King Machine. Thank you.